Hello, I'm Shane from ActiveGrowth.com, and I want to make a quick tutorial for Ahrefs. This is a keyword research and SEO tutorial that goes with a podcast episode we did with Tim Solo. So I simply want to show how to do one of the things he describes in the podcast, because I think it's easier to understand when you see it instead of just hearing it. So here we go. We are in Google, and let's say we've done a search for something in our niche. So I chose productivity, so let's say how to be more productive, and we see what this page looks like. And I'm just going to scroll down to the first result here and click on this, because this is what we're saying is we want to be not only looking at the keyword, but exploring what are the top ranking pages for the keyword doing. So right here, this is the number one after the special stuff at the top, right? In the actual search results, this is the number one article that is listed. So then let's grab this URL here. I'll copy this and go into Ahrefs. In Ahrefs, I'm in the site explorer right here, and I'll paste this specific URL in here. And then we can search and we get an analysis of this specific article, right? We can also get an analysis of the domain that it sits on, but in this case, we're interested in stuff about this article that ranks number one for the keyword we chose. And here, this, first of all, this is what Tim was talking about. This is an estimate, the organic traffic. This is an estimate of the monthly search traffic coming to this URL, right? So this is basically calculated not only on the specific keyword, but on all the keywords it ranks for and the positions it has. And we can get more information on this on organic search here in the organic search tab. So first of all, we can see over time how search has developed. And then here we can see organic keywords, and we can see how that has developed. So what we can see here is this is the number of keywords that Ahrefs has found for this article where it's in the top 100, right? So that is not page one, right? It's not 144 page one keywords. But what you can see here is that it has, we have three different categories. We have positions 1 to 3, positions 4 to 10, and then positions 11 to 100. So if we look here, you can see that for 30 different keywords, this article is in the top three spots. And this is what Tim was talking about, right? If you simply plug in the search volume for one keyword, it shows you how many people are searching for that keyword, which is interesting to know. But that doesn't show you how many people come to this URL, right? Because it's actually ranking in the top three for 30 different keywords. And we can also have a look at what those keywords are. We can see here the different organic positions for different keywords. But here, so here you can see the top five organic keywords sending traffic to this article. And one of them is how to be more productive. One of them is how to become more productive, how to become more productive in a different location, how to be productive, be more productive. And you can see how it ranks in different spots for these different keywords, and all of that combines together into a certain amount of traffic. So this is a great way to systematically discover other keywords that are relevant as well. So instead of kind of just guessing or using, you know, a keyword planner that shows you ad related keywords, you can actually look at, okay, a different article, what keywords is it ranking for? And what other keywords would make sense to target? And this could be targeting, you might want to try and mix in these variations in a single post, but this could also be a clue for what to create SEO landing pages for, right? What different aspects do you want to have separate pages for to explain different aspects of your product or your service or whatever it is that you're doing SEO for? We can also get more, we can basically dig deeper into this. On the sidebar, we have more options here, and one of them is organic keywords. And here you can see a full list. So the other one was the top ones, and here you can see a full list of all these different variations that are all bringing traffic in to this page in some way. And so another thing we can do is we can pick a different keyword like becoming productive and then do a search for that. And that gives us a new list of results. And once again, it gives us multiple pages that we can go and analyze. And so this is how we can much more quickly arrive at an idea of, okay, what are people searching for? What content is ranking? And also, how much traffic are these articles actually getting? How much traffic are these pages actually getting, not only from the keywords I'm searching for? So So that's the Site Explorer in Ahrefs and this specific strategy that Tim mentions in the podcast. So if you're watching this on YouTube, you have no idea what I'm talking about. I'll put the link in the description to that podcast episode. Tim Solo, who is a leading expert in the SEO space, shared a lot of great strategies for how you can bootstrap SEO, so how you can start doing search engine optimization without needing a huge budget. So the link to that is in the description.